Welcome all to Ron's Tech Reviews. In this video, we'll be unboxing the Seasonic Prime TX-750. First, a little bit about Seasonic. Seasonic is one of the most trusted power supply manufacturer. I'd say they are the best manufacturer out there. They released the Prime TX and the PX series PSUs at the end of 2019. The TX series is the top of the line model. This one we have here is the Prime TX-750, meaning it's a 750 watt PSU and a 80 plus titanium rated. On top of the box, we find the 80 plus titanium badging and the couple of awards they have won over the years. On the side, we find the specifications and the list of cables that come along with the box. At the back, we will find more details. As mentioned before, this is an 80 plus titanium certified, making this even at 10% load 90% efficient, meaning there is only 7.5 watts loss when it's connected to a system that is idling at about 75 watts. This is a fully modular power supply, so you can connect the cables that you want to the PSU and leave out the rest. It has a 135mm fluid dynamic bearing fan and has an industry leading warranty of 12 years. Next, we see that the PSU has a premium hybrid fan mode, which is nothing but a silent mode where the fan is totally off at low loads and it slowly ramps up as the load increases. So this is about 40%, it is silent, and then it goes up. That's pretty much it, what's written on the box. Now let's move on to the opening of it. I will use my trusted IKEA knife. Opening it up, we find this Ziploc bag. In it, it contains a branded Velcro ties, 5 of them, seems of good quality. Then we have zip ties, the mounting screws, and the Seasonic badge which you can stick onto your case. Then we have the instructions for a chance to win a $50 Steam coupon, the quick start guide, the detailed user manual, and now the PSU self-starter tester, which I will show you guys later in this video. Here then we have the US socket power plug. Next we have the pouch that I believe contains all of the cables that go into the PSU. Okay, we have one bag and then another one. Let's open the first bag. We first have this 24-pin motherboard cable, the 6 8-pin PCIe cables, 4 of them, the 4 plus 4 or 8 pin CPU cables, 2 of them. Then we have the Molex to SATA adapter, now let's open the second bag. In this we have all the peripheral connectors, that is the Molex and the SATA cables. In total we have like 3 SATA cables that can connect up to 10 devices and 2 Molex cables to connect up to 5 devices. Now coming to the main event of the video, the PSU itself. You can know this is a premium PSU from how they have packed this. It comes with a very nice quality velvet bag, and this PSU itself feels quite heavy. The metal here is very pleasing to touch. Not that this matters, as this is going to be hidden in your PC. At the side where we connect the power cable to the PSU, we will find also the on-off switch and the hybrid mode switch. At the sides, we will find the aerodynamic scoops, which does functionally nothing, but it makes the PSU look good. We also have some chrome on the ventilation side of the intake side of the fan. And finally, coming to the back of the PSU, this is where we find all the ports, where we connect all the cables that I showed you earlier. Now let's try turning this on. We first connect the power cable to the power supply. Make sure the hybrid mode is off so that the fan turns when we turn the power supply on. And then we connect the motherboard cable. And on the other side of the motherboard cable, which usually goes into the motherboard, we will connect the cell starter bridge. Fingers crossed, I hope this turns on. Yes, it did. Okay, I'm so happy it turns on. I don't have to RMA this. Looking closer, you can see the fan is spinning. Turning the hybrid mode on, we'll see the fan slowly ramping down and it comes to a full stop. Running the PSU in this mode is quite helpful. It saves the fan from getting worn out and it is totally silent in this mode. Turning off the hybrid mode, the fan starts turning again. The sound is quite low and you won't hear anything much. That brings us to the end of this video. If you would like to buy this power supply, please check out the description below. I have put the links from where you can buy the power supply. I got this power supply from Newegg for $200 and I believe that is about the right price. So don't buy if it's priced above that. I hope you all liked this video. Please click the like button if you did. Drop in your comments. Click the subscribe and the bell icon to be notified on my future videos. Stay home and stay safe. Take care.